So, nearly 20 years ago now, I decided I needed a project. And my project was to get shed loads of cartoon videotapes, capture their intros, and make them a little bit cleaner and put them into a format whereby I could do a video CD of a lot of old cartoon intros. This is that video CD, 20 years later. The reason I'm doing this now is that in order to have a crack at monetizing this channel, I need to get rid of all my many beloved cartoon intros that have been on this channel for 15 years, but which are too small and too lacking in commentary for YouTube's monetization purposes these days. This video may not get monetized, but because I'm here and I'm talking over the top of it a lot, it should mean that I can keep video content, even if it can't be monetized, it won't block monetization. That's the plan. As a bonus, you'll get a little bit of me squidged into the picture over here to maybe get fewer copyright hits, maybe, not so sure, but might work. And you'll also see videos here that have not been on the channel before because I felt they were too low quality or I just didn't get around to it 15 years ago or whatever. But this is all of them that I did, I think, pretty much without gaps. So I'm live and unscripted. I'm going to watch the whole video CD with you as I would have done back in the day. And basically, if you're unfamiliar, this is basically a precursor to DVDs. So it's an ancient disc-based video format. I think came just before DVDs, but you put it onto a normal CD-ROM. You encoded it in such a way that a computer or a DVD player could understand it, and you played it. It's actually an hour. It's a good hour long. And you can put sort of text screens up and stuff, and you'll see there are these random text screens that refer to my website, which is still up. And they call it freeware. And they call out when it was a DVD, it was available. And of course, you know, these days, pretty much everything that is on this video CD is available. So do, of course, feel free to purchase actual episodes. But these are just the intros, just for nostalgia, just for the purposes of review. And let's kick it off, shall we? This is a bit new for me. This is all very high tech for my purposes. I'm using OBS to do this. So this is just my introductory text. This, all these openings and stuff were grabbed from videotapes somewhere between, well, like 35 and 40 years ago now. yeah, I'm just a hobbyist, so this doesn't mean that the quality of the material varies depending on how good the tape was. It's on a DVD, just said that. It's an interactive menus, it just sort of goes. And VLC actually plays this really, really nicely for me, so I recorded it off VLC. Because when I got my shiny new PC, I made damn sure that I had a disk drive with it so I could do random stuff like this for you. And maybe a little bit for me as well. Okay. And these got my web address on the top right corner as well, as encoded. I shied away from doing that when I put them on YouTube properly, but I used to have it on there. Now this is my 80s cartoon mix video, which has been up on my site for donkey's ears. The weird thing doing it like this is that I can't actually hear the video myself. Not quite sure why not. But I edited this together in such a way that the lyrical bits I picked out, in theory, make a bit of sense as it goes from one cartoon to another. So if you listen to it, and you listen to the words, you will probably be able to figure out what I was trying to do with it. So this is Visionaries, Defenders of the Earth. Who else we got? Dungeons and Dragons, great show. They never got home in the series, but they were supposed to, is my understanding. Had they actually done the last episodes? Cavalier, Acrobat, Ulysses 31, another favourite of mine when I was growing up. Great Spaceships, Thunderbirds 2086. Originally a Japanese cartoon, and they just converted it into a sort of Thunderbirds based thing. Inspector Gadget, one of my biggest viewed video intros when it was here. Mask, Mobile Armored Strike Command, Various masks, when energized, give them various special superpowers, transforming vehicles, battle of the planets, also known as Gatchaman. Protect the Earth from threats beyond our galaxy, apparently. It makes sense, Sevenzox 7, the really annoying character. There are many really annoying characters. I've developed a phrase that RAC use for really annoying characters. Snarf, really annoying character. So, Man and Machine, here we go. Boys like their toys, sometimes they wear them, sometimes they drive them, sometimes they fly them. Here are some imaginative examples of all three. Fade. Nice. Centurions. In the near future, bear in mind, In the near future, Doc Terror. Only one force can stop. And I'm doing that in part because I think it might possibly rip the right place. Ace of the Cloud, Jake Rockwell, who's the sea guy? I'm up with the sea guys. That's him. Air guy. Max Ray, brilliant sea operations commander. If I could hear the sound, I could tell you who he is. I'm sure you're shouting at me in the comments already. Jake Rockwell, rugged land operations specialist. Hackles, the daring air operations expert. Can't have been Doctor Doom, surely not. That's Strafer. I had a toy of Ace of the Cloud as well, great toys. Part of the reason why I'm collecting toys at the moment is I want to get stuff like this back again because it was cool. His mask, Rebel Armored Strike Command. Toys of this do very well apparently as well. And there were lots of toys. I mean, mask was properly weaponized when it came to toys. All the figures, all the masks. I've been playing with them a lot. A friend of mine had quite a few of them actually. That's the annoying character that's transformed. Mighty Bot guy. I don't know his name. That's Thunderhawk, I think. Hypos, the transforming helicopter jet. We wanted that as well. That's quite expensive these days. The helicopter and the jet. It's cool. It's great. I didn't have them. I didn't get used to them. Rhino was the truck. Pole position is quite an obscure one. From now on, so this is like Knight Rider on steroids with more children, basically. So it's supercars, can do various stunts, and they have AIs on board, and so on and so forth, all that good stuff. Some detective kids. Okay, here we go. Transformation of those. Oh, look at that. What a great AI face that is. Hydrofoil mode, Rody. Hydrofoil mode. Use the hover car. And water ski mode, there we go. And we absolutely have to go for a swim, except for substitutes. There's the car mode. There we go. And there's a really annoying character with an ill-fitting helmet. Excellent. It is hair. Ball position. Now, Silverhawks. Now, I never saw this in the UK, but I understand it is quite a popular show in the States, and I have seen toys of it in the Leicester Vintage and Old Toy Store. And I think it has a Thundercats connection. I believe it's the same people who did this, and vaguely similar premise, maybe. But it's a very cool intro. The funny thing about intros is, with cartoons from the 80s, they put a shed load of cash into the catchy themes and the quality of animation in the intros. The quality of the animation in the actual shows tends to be far below the level of the intros. I hate to burst the bubble, but it is, generally speaking. But the intros rock. Quite frequently, they just rock. And that's what I remember of the shows quite a lot. It's, you know, it's the theme tunes, and it's the intros, and it's all that sort of good stuff. And it's, you know, it gets you into the show, gets you in the mood. I can't talk too much because I'll run out of voice, but I am trying to put a little bit of voice over each one by way of commentary. And as I say, just to try and avoid sort of copyrighty flavoured shenanigans. Thunderbirds 2086, love this one. Got the annual in a bookcase over there, and there's a video of the annual on the channel as well. Because the drawings in the annual are beautiful of the vehicles, and they had shed load of vehicles. Can't remember exactly how many, but it was probably way more. They had the core vehicles, like in the original Thunderbirds, but they also had shed loads more vehicles as well, and there were sort of space specialists and, you know, all sorts of stuff. Really interesting concept, and yet it was never designed to be a Thunderbird show. Strange but true, but it lent itself to it really well. Yeah, Thunderbird 3 is a big truck, which is a bit of a letdown to the original series, but there are plenty of other really cool spaceships in it to counterbalance that fact, which is fine. And they get to their ships on flying surfboards, which also gets bonus cool points. So you can go. The classic anime uniforms, it's just like, you know, I wouldn't have known that at the time. For me, it was just another cartoon at the time, so I wouldn't have known what anime was when I was watching it, but that's pretty much what it is. That's the Willy 4, which is fair to use, because that is built like a Thunderbird 4 type vehicle. In the space age technology of the 21st century. It's 5 a space station. A special rescue squad ready to enter a space station. That's Thunderbird 2, which looks more like Thunderbird 4. Thunderbird 1 is a space shuttle, which is docked up there. Did it just launch without already attached to it? And then it comes out of around the 80s from here. Whoops. Continuity error, first time I've ever noticed that. There you go. Visionaries, Knights of the Magical Light, also like this one. More powerful than science. They have used rhymes to access their powers. They can transform destiny. Into holograms of their visionaries. Themselves. The vehicles have hologram powers, their staffs have powers. They can only use them once, and they had to be recharged by more. So you had to sort of, you had to pick your moment. That was the thing. So, and you can depower your foes as well in some of the vehicles. Animal magic, cats, rats, dogs, turtles, lizards, monkeys. It's anthropomorphism gone mad, I tell you, mad. You also get the benefit of my voiceover, so you didn't have that in the original video CD. Dogtanian and the Three Muskehounds. I loved this show. I can't really explain why, but I did love it. Might have had a slight crush on the princess. It's possible. It's, you know, it's Dogtanian and the Three Musketeers, basically. It's like, you know, it's very cleverly done. It was actually quite an accurate retelling of the actual story, the original story as well. There was some good swordplay in it as well. I mean, it was well animated of its sort. Spanish, produced by a Spanish company. Interesting. These are things I now pick up because I'm just sort of looking at it in a more sort of critical eye. That is going to hurt. Yeah. That's really going to hurt. I mean, that's just harsh. That's not Richelieu. That's Richelieu. That's Richelieu, yeah. I love how I'm pointing at the TV like you're watching the same thing I am. It's just that. Sorry. Yeah. Original script. Great name. How can he see to sword fight? He's got a fringe right over his eyes. That's crazy. Just saying. I feel that's unrealistic, Dogtanian. Bless him. We don't like you. You've got an eye patch. That means you're evil. Sorry. Check this. Yeah, eat your heart out, Obi-Wan. Ah, you just fry the apple. He can actually make it into convenient apple slices. Yes, based on a famous novel by Alexandre Dumas, apparently. Honor and friendship. Wakanda forever and all that good stuff. Yeah. Adventures of the Gummi Bears. Yeah, Disney kids. How I didn't get sued for this one, I don't know. I don't think they're really in the current Disney stable, but perhaps they'll come back one day. I mean, you know, everything old seems to be again at some point. See? They're complete earworms. I can't help it. don't actually know why I've even got the headphones on, because you can't hear this, so I can just take the headphones off, but I've got one now, I'm taking them off. I'm going to try now. I really thought I'd be able to hear it through my headphones, but OBS must not do that. If I record it for an hour and it turns out there's been no sound whatsoever from the videos, I'm going to be upset. I did test this when I started, so it should be okay. If my lips are in sync with the sound, that'll be a miracle. If you're still watching it now, that'll be a miracle. Heathcliff. Now, I'm not sure I had this video interrupt before, actually. Again, I don't know. He looks a bit like Garfield, but he was very distinctly different to Garfield. I don't know how well known he is generally, Heathcliff. I don't even know if we've got any toys for him, to be honest. Maybe we did. Shoot, which is clearly too small to take, though, quite frankly. And then they got a flying bathtub. So that's not good. You flying around on top of a rocket and a dog gets singed, that hardly seems fun. So, yeah. No idea who he is. That's Heathcliff, I don't know who the other guy is. This is arch nemesis. Teenage Mutant Hero / Ninja Turtles. They couldn't call it Ninja in the UK, and they couldn't have nunchucks and all that sort of good stuff because they were deemed too violent for us sensitive British types. So that's why we got the heroes, and everyone else got the ninjas. Because obviously they are ninjas, actually. But we got this sort of watered down version. So you see, you don't see the nunchucks. You can have sides, you can have the doodah staffs, but you can't have nunchucks apparently. Too nasty. Splinter. I have very fond memories of playing the arcade version of this when I wasn't supposed to be in the arcade when I was quite young. It's a great arcade game though. Okay. Drone. And you would want to run away because they don't have power to take on that sort of vehicle. Thundercats! Thundercats. Alright, now it's in. Sorry, I was early. Such a great show. Again, not what I had toys for. I think it was probably one of those ones where the toys I felt weren't accurate enough, if I were to guess. Plus, I was going through a massive Transformers phase at this point as well, so unfortunately, Thundercats probably didn't quite make it for me. That Panthro cut is really odd. I think people on the individual video used to call that out as being just odd. I don't know if it replaced something that they couldn't show. Maybe it was him doing his nunchucks. It could have been a nunchuck issue, I'm pretty sure he had nunchucks. So it could have been that. I mean, British kids' TV was so heavily edited. It was quite funny because I remember showing my son the Back to the Future film, and it was so much swearier than I thought it was going to be, because we got the watered-down version and we got the edited version. You know, when you get Yippee-ki-yo, Muddy Chickens or something for Die Hard and all that sort of stuff. Top Cat. Now, Top Cat's quite well known. It's not actually in the car, obviously. It's a cunning visual toy. He is, in fact, sitting outside the car. He's clever. He's got a retractable tipping board as well, which is... They're in my head. Everything was quests. Three guesses what's going now. So many tunes you needed to watch every week to keep up with the unfolding story. Which of these did you follow? I mean, you got they did have ongoing storylines, some of them, you know. Dungeons and Dragons, kids. If I'd misspelt that for a moment, I don't know why. "Hey, it's the Dungeons and Dragons ride." "Yes, it is. Beware fantasy wormholes and stranger things." It's quite funny because this is smack out of the era of Stranger Things. That's what's funny about that comment. That's Tiamat, isn't it? That's Dungeon Master. And the Ranger, Barbarian, a Magician, Acrobats, Cavalier. I missed somebody, didn't I? Thief. Avenger. Bouncy Shield. Avenger legging it. RAC alert. It's Uni the Unicorn. She's an RAC. Jayce the Wheeled Warriors. Partly penned by JMS of Babylon 5 fame, of course, kids. Oh, yes. I recently discovered there were toys of this. I didn't have the pocket money for them when I was last in Leicester, but at some point I might well try and obtain a toy of Jayce the Wheeled Warriors because they were cool. Never knew if it was Master Minds or Master Vines. I never quite figured that one out. I'm sure if I looked it up, I'd find out in about 2 seconds flat. But basically, it was a quest to find two halves of Magic Root, combine it, defeat Monster Minds. That was the idea. And they had various vehicles we could reconfigure, swap weapons with each other. All very cool. All very cool. And had like a Han Solo guy piloting the ship. She was borderline the really annoying character, but not quite. She was an empath, actually, if I remember rightly. You see, you wonder where all these concepts come from that now turn up on regular races in sci-fi. This is kind of the starting point for a lot of it, really. You might even call her a telepath if you were to push it. So that's one bit of magic ring, I think. Was that just a magic? That was just a magic ring. Now this one might get me into hot water, so I'm going to speak really loudly over this one, because this one actually got taken off my channel recently because somebody claimed the copyright on it much harder than I'm used to. It wasn't just a question of sort of doing a gentle claim on it, they actually had it properly nobbled. So they dream of following the path of the setting sun this one that leads to El Dorado. They were pretty hardcore, and I don't think anyone else has got Mysterious Cities of Gold up anymore in intro format or anything else for that matter. A little bit naughty because it's just a review, it's a small segment. For copyright purposes, they shouldn't be able to do it. And I tried to challenge it back, and they didn't respond. And their lack of a response counted against me and not them. It's harsh, really. I mean, don't try that at home, kids, please. Don't jump off high places without... No, just don't. I'm pretty sure that... I'm surprised that got past the censors, actually. That's just silly. It is. I mean, you're not going to get a golden condor coming to help. I'm sorry, that's just not going to happen. So I'm really hoping I've got enough of the picture out that they're not going to be upset with me for including this one. I've forgotten about that. That could be interesting. I might have to edit this bit down. In which case, I'll see you on the next one. And I'm back, or I was never gone, to be honest, points of view. Ulysses 31. Oh, yes. Toys of this.
It is the 31st century. Ulysses killed the giant Cyclops when he rescued the children and his son Telemachus. But the ancient gods of Olympus are angry and threaten a terrible revenge.
Mortals, you defy the gods! I sentence you to travel among unknown stars until you find the kingdom of Hades. Your body will stay as lifeless as stone.
Ulysses, the way back to Earth has been wiped from my memory.
Father! Oh, Father!
You are alive, my son.
She gets the star maps wiped, so they've got no choice but to play along. And again, I think it was quite accurate to the actual original myth. Remember rightly. Ulysses had his own space stuff as well. It was cool. There are toys.
There are toys for that one.
Yeah. And other spaces as well, not just figures. Some of the spaces as well. Is that a Grail toy for me? Gratuitous marketing for it. Why have one special? Yeah, we get it. It spits apart into sound. It's funny watching it from the sort of marketing element of the joke. Not that I have marketing element of the joke. Being a bit of a completist, and if I could get hold of it, I encoded it. All the classics were getting adapted. There's not an original thought amongst it, it's just adaptations of old school stuff. Is that the same guy who adopted? Is that the same name as Dogtanian? Maybe he has something to do with Dogtanian as well. I've only just noticed that. Bear in mind, I haven't watched this for years. I mean, literally years. In fact, I was going to show you that this is the. That's the original disc. Look at that. See? 80s VCD, version 1.0, 30th of March, 03. Nearly 20 years old at the time we recorded. And it still works! Put that in the machine, it still works! We always used to say those discs would degrade over time. Apparently not so much if you're careful with them, kids. Is it nearly finished yet? Yes. In hospital bed. Space Invaders. Okay, here we go. Before Will Smith started dealing with the worst scum of the universe, a few other individuals were taking care of business. Sounds so much cooler when I say it out loud. Or does it? Of all the planets, aka Gatchman. Is it Science Ninja Team? Something like that as well? Yeah. I had a God Phoenix 2. That's God Phoenix 1. I had God Phoenix 2. They go for shed loads of cash now in decent condition. I have no idea why I had it or where I got it from, but I remember having it in Anglesey in the early 80s. A little yellow vehicle inside it, and a beak that opened up and stuff. I have no idea why I had it. I have no idea what business it had being in Britain, because it's Japanese. So I've got nothing. It also had the Sparta Gatchaman. It's like this big multi-piece ship that sort of slotted together to form a big arrowhead formation. Nothing to do with this series at all. Came much later, I think, but I had that as well. Again, no idea why. Probably from the same shop, I guess. But I have no idea why that would be important to Anglesey at the time. Again, this was a classic example of a show that was massively edited for the American/British market, because the original one was far more anime, far more Japanese. There was a lot more violence, children. Acting as one. The Fiery Phoenix. The ultimate get-out-of-jail-free card when you're really in a bit of a pickle. Defenders of the Earth, Flash Gordon, and guests, basically. Now, I'm not sure which comic stable these guys actually originally came from, because we saw a few of these, because we got Phantom, and he had his own film in the late 80s. Phantom. It's me. Master of magic spells and Mandrake. Enemies crumble in fear and confusion. Yeah, that's the one. His strength is a legend. His no idea what else he's in. Armed with his power, we never will fall. And of course, their kids start getting in the fun. With our new young heroes, which there must have been twins of this. Or becoming, didn't have any defending the earth. Defenders of the earth. Defenders of the Earth. That's not the right sort of show, I think. is mine, even Starfleet. Don't get rid of these videos off the site as well, though. Off the channel, because YouTube will not like the owners, just the original clips to have any commentary on them. So I suspect that they will stop me getting monetized as well, because they're just the clips. So they'll probably have to go as well. Annoying as that is, they'll probably have to go as well.
Space pilot Hagen, sir.
Space pilot John Lee.
Barry, I'm Barry Hurt.
I've got him now. I've got a Japanese toy. ST variety of him as well. Excellent. Terrahawks.
Terrahawks, stay on this channel. This is an emergency.
I've seen get taken down. So let's hope that we're taken down. Can you imagine the copyright claims that we could get on this? Quite pricey. I have seen them, and there were some very nice examples of them. I haven't bought any. Heroes and heroines. Some characters just won't be in a show unless they get top billing. Here are some of the show stealers, apparently. I don't know where I'm going with this one. Okay, Captain Planet. Yeah. In peril. Gaia, the spirit of early environmentalism. Very early environmentalism, actually, when you think about it. Really good intro, though. Magic rings to five special young people. It's a little bit sort of Green Lantern-esque. I think the Green Lantern's going to sue somebody, basically. Bring some power, you see. It's going to the elemental power trope there. Earth, wind, fire, sort of stuff. They're very international team as well, you'll notice. And interestingly, a good mix of male and female characters as well. It's quite common in cartoons, even back then, you see, because the cartoons were quite pushing that sort of approach to life, which is good. That's why, you know, people of my age are so well balanced. Captain Planet and the Planeteers. Gem. Looking at you, Gav. He knows who he is. If he ever actually watches this. On the lips. Shocking. Gem versus the Misfits, as I recall. I knew of this, I don't think I particularly watched it for obvious reasons, but they're the Misfits, there you go. Evil rock band versus good rock band. Tale as old as time. That. Okay. Recently reinvented by Kevin Smith and Co. It's really cleverly done as well. Really clever. If you haven't caught it on Netflix, you should do, because it's very, very cleverly done. It's got a lot of love for the original. Interesting, this is one intro that hasn't been, that doesn't get extra polished. This is what the cartoon looks like, in fairness to them. And this is another one that JMS actually had a hand in, which I hadn't realised. But I think he was involved with He-Man. And then I think they left because they wanted to change it or something. Something made him go, I think. I can't remember exactly what happened now. The most powerful man in the universe. And I think they weren't allowed to use guns. They some, they had to use kind of, they had to use things that were like real guns, they had to be like laser guns, that was one of the rules of the good formation. So they had to tread quite carefully with how they did things. So you know, you can have a walking skeleton as the baddie, but you can't have guns. And of course, you can't have Heat Man.
I am Adora, He-Man's twin sister, and defender of the Crystal Castle. This is Spirit, my beloved steed. Fabulous secrets were revealed to me the day I held aloft my sword and said, "For the honor of Grayskull!"
It's still the Grayskull tying there, you see. It's not the same. Quite a clever thing to do.
Only a few others share this secret. Among them are Lightfoot, Madam Raz, and Cowl. Together, we and my friends of the Great Rebellion strive to free Etheria from the evil forces of Horda.
Again, never got into He-Man toys like at all. That would have been a complete cash sink. Big guns. When the going gets rough, the tough get going. Sometimes harsh language and batarangs just won't cut it. Then it's time to call in the professionals. A.K.A. G.I. Joe. But in Britain, we got Action Force, because we're terribly British. I'm assuming the toys were the same, but as I say, we just got this Action Force rebranding. And these guys actually turned up in the Transformers comic quite a bit at points as well in the 80s. They did sort of crossovers. And I believe Megatron actually got rebuilt by Cobra at one point, as I recall. So they had quite a significant tie-in with one another. I don't know if the toys actually tied in as such, but the comics definitely did. JMS involved with this one again. It's funny how many of these cartoons have a little bit of his touch in them. It's just really interesting. This was a really good show as well. I mean, there were good stories in the Real Ghostbusters. and they look like the characters as well. There was another one called just kind of Ghostbusters, I think, but this is. They had to call this one the Real Ghostbusters to distinguish it, I believe, because there was already a cartoon that called itself Ghostbusters but wasn't associated with the film. There are toys of that one as well, and I know the lads from the Leicester store pick up those toys from time to time. Again, better sort of artwork on the intro than on the actual series itself with this one. Robotech, yeah. Again, this is when I picked up off the tape, and I knew of Robotech, and I knew that a Transformer was originally based off a Robotech Valkyrie. Because I used to get old American comics. I say old, they were new at the time, they're old now. And I'd see adverts for Robotech in them, so I knew what it was. And I recognised the Jetfire toy from those adverts, but you know, you never saw the toys in this country unless you were very lucky, I think, at that point. Much more commonplace now. And I have seen the animations as well. The anime's good. It's good. Very fascinating, anime, I think it's fair to say. In fact, it's one of those weird ones where they sort of, again, I think they took a different series and called it Robotech. There's one where all the sort of the tech kind of changes in a really odd way, and I think they had to really stretch it to make it fit Robotech, but yeah. Which one that was? Just great space combat and stuff. It's just, you know, it's really cool stuff. Really
or pay the consequences.
Again, not one I watched at the time. I can't even remember how I managed to find the video for it. There used to be these videotapes you could get which had like three episodes from three different series on them. I think it was one of those sorts of tapes that I got this from. If you're wondering, I actually had, at one point, I even had an NTSC. We used PAL in this country for analog videos. The States used NTSC, so when I got videos from the States, I used an NTSC video recorder. And I fed that output, which is a video recorder I was using, into a thing called a Canopus AVDC, which is analog to digital video conversion AVDC. And I fed that into my ancient at the time PC. Incredibly processor intensive thing to then convert the video, but that's how I created these little intros. But now, so, you know, everything's getting digitized, so it doesn't matter anymore. But Starcom, another one I did not have the toys for, which I would have expected myself to have the toys for, quite frankly, because it's very spacey. But again, I don't remember seeing this cartoon for it at the time. And the intro is really good. I mean, the intro is just sort of solid. You know, I can recognize the vehicles straight from the intro, no problem at all. I probably would have quite liked it. But I never quite got into the toys. There's a really annoying character even in that intro for this. It's like, why is there a Katniss active military space carrier? That's so crazy. Why was the point of giving the bloody fighter crap? Okay, it's an asteroid base. Fair dues. Yes, I am the evil one, for I have lots of faceless goons. Because we can't be bothered to animate faces slots. Time saving that. Ooh, cool. Just completely missing the small fighter craft because they're fighter craft and captain ships. Laser beams, just want to see. It's supposed to be US Space Force. The law. Cop show is a pretty universal concept, but when it gets the tune treatment, anything can happen, and often does. I still quite like my intros. Bravestarr. Bravestarr, God, got nearly a million views on Bravestarr. I've been on this channel for 15 years, got nearly a million views, and still loads of people are watching it. I think it's having a renaissance. Seeing the toys are still around. Again, never had any of the blinking toys, but I like the talking horse. You're going to see him in a minute. Bravestarr. And far away place. I'm going to get his numbers wrong. I'm not going to say his numbers, so I'll just get them wrong. So he has numbers in his name. Two of them. Eyes of the Hawk. Strength of the Bear. Speed of the Hawk.
And one day a llama.
Is that it?
With powers of Pop, Wolf, Puma, and Bear.
Fox.
Man from afar. Champion of justice, mortal brave star.
I should have done my homework, didn't I, really? There he is. I was going 30-30, maybe it's 20-20. Central organization of police specialists. I think that is actually an acronym.
Protecting Empire City from Big Boss and his gang.
It's the veteran to the kingpin. Donuts back on. Judge Dredd, it ain't, but you know. A gentleman has issues. You would have good guns in your tummy, wouldn't you, really? Bazooka. Get a bit of a laser bazooka. is that they've been colored, folks.
It's crime fighting time.
Or something, I think. It's a catchphrase. Again, never had the toys. Never saw the show. But it looks cool. Seeking our help. Another Cowboys in Space return, show, kids.
They gave us the plans for our first hyperdrive.
Allowing mankind
to open the doors to the stars.
Rightly.
We have assembled a team of individuals to protect Earth and our allies.
We've got about 20 minutes left. Committed to the highest sponsorship ideals mission. Of justice. That's a bit of a marathon
to preserving
one.
Law and order across the new frontier. These are the
I'll chapter it up for you. And then you can just jump to the appropriate spot if you want a particular intro. That might be the best way to do it, I think. I'm sorry if my window is interrupting your viewing pleasure, but as I say, it's probably kind of necessary to just try and get away with this, I think, I'm afraid. People just aren't as lenient as they used to be. You know, I used to be able to put this stuff up and it wouldn't even get, and it wouldn't bat an eyelid. Inspector Gadget, here we go. This is another really, really popular one. There's a lot of love for Inspector Gadget out there. Classic sort of bungling detective guy with lots of random stuff that he can do. And they did do live action movies of him as well at one point. I don't really know what people think of them. I don't think I ever really sat and watched them, to be honest, because this is how I remember him. So he's got his boss that always ends up getting blown up, bless him, like that. And then he's got a dog and his niece, who's Penny, who's trying to keep him out of trouble all the time. He's got a transforming car as well. I mean, he had a cool kit. I actually wonder how much of him is actually him. I mean, he seems to be pretty sort of Robocop-y when all said and done. If you actually think about how many bits of him actually extend and stuff, it's quite disturbing. Yeah. And the claws got down. It's a fun show. That is. Yeah. Before the prequels went into production, the Star Wars universe was extended on the small screen by some animated adventures of familiar and not so familiar characters. Dig R2-D2's moonwalking. Yeah. This. You can get toys of this. I mean, of course you can. It's Star Wars. Of course you can get toys of it. But there are toys just of this little cartoon. I don't know how many episodes it had.
Everywhere.
But I got... This came in a weird cardboard slit kind of video case, not a plastic one. It's really odd. I think I got it in a second hand shop. Just
if you don't mind my saying,
did I get it off of eBay?
I don't think this is a safe place, actually. Man or droid. That fellow over
a bunch of my old videos actually got stolen, like, I think, when I was going to give them back to a charity shop to be passed on. It's really annoying. My car got stolen, the videos were in the car.
He's the one we're here
sod's
to see.
Law, isn't it? Yeah.
Good to see you again, Croc.
Yeah, so R2 being R2 has to go mess with the jukebox, of course.
You and everyone else wants, Mungo. I've been one step ahead of Imperial Stormtroopers.
I mean, yeah, this is like Mandalorian, is basically. It's kind of, you know. Yeah, no, it's not. But is it? It's expanding, you know, this was the expanded universe in terms of Star Wars at that time. You had this and you had Ewoks as well, which will be the next one. Yeah, check it out. See, it's R2 moonwalking. Yeah, look at that. Wow. Loving your work, R2. That's beautiful. Now he's breakdancing because everyone did breakdancing in the 80s, obviously.
Nice doing business with you. See you around.
Oh dear. Now what do we do, Mr. Munger?
Keep calm. Maybe they're not looking for us.
You're I don't even know what that guy's name is.
Then again, I could be wrong.
I'm not actually sure if that was supposed to be pre-Star Wars, actually. That might be what I was saying in my intro, actually. That was actually before Star Wars. That's before A New Hope. And here comes the Ewoks. Yeah, they weaponized the Ewoks into an animated series. And there was a film, of course, as well. It was just Ewoks. I can kind of picture it, but the name won't come to me. But they did try and do something a little bit of the Ewoks. I feel like the... Yeah, Wookiee holiday special thing. It's not good. He's a shapeshifter, apparently.
I knew that. What do you think I am? A
remember having the Ewok action. I had some Ewok action figures. W. Warwick and all that good stuff. How about some more changes, Ring? Sadly, I do not have any of my Star Wars toys anymore. Which is, has to concentrate to help me transform. As I'm sure it is for a lot of people, a source of great pain. Very good reproductions being done now, though. Go hand it to them. So these are just clips. I don't think these videos had intros as such, or not that I had available to me when I was doing my stuff, so I just had to do little clips of these ones. Nothing else I could do. Robots. Often in disguise, there are more than met the eye. You can buy Transformers on DVD, of course you can. Yeah. Buy a lot more than that these days, kids. Even in 2000, you see, they hadn't really come back at this point. But this is the Gobots, also known as Machine Robos. And of course, the Gobots didn't survive the Hasbro Transformers, and didn't wipe them out. But it was Bandai, wasn't it? I'm pretty sure this would be Bandai. They didn't fight the overwhelming power of Transformers. And here they are. Seamless. Look at that, seamless. That's Unicron's head. So this is actually the intro from the third season of the original G1 Transformers cartoon. Which I believe is generally regarded as being a bit pants, which means not very good for those of you who are not familiar with that term. From my generation, it was a bit rubbish. I mean, it had some great characters in it, but they didn't use the same people as were in the Transformers the movie, so it didn't, and the animation quality was just so much below the movie. It's glucose overload time, folks. Brace yourself, yeah. Apologies in advance, Care Bears. Now I'm glad I don't have the sound, because that would have been unacceptable, quite frankly. There's another Gav on this. He knows who he is. Care Bears Movie 2, A New Generation. Oh, I can feel my blood sugar rising now. Good Lord. There's films where every single character is an RAC. Yeah. Why are they twins? Might be the coolest character in the whole show, if possible. She's losing the will to live territory, this kid. Yeah, we've seen that one before. He's not hit the ground yet. I mean, come on. Cloud cars. All right, fair enough. Points for flying cars. Being charitable. Just no, no, not a talking star. No, just no, go away. Oh, Denver, the Last Dinosaurs. There is a lot of love for Denver. Because Denver quite literally rocks. Yeah, that's Denver, he's a dinosaur. That happens, yeah. Too lazy to hatch at the right time, so he just hatches randomly. Happens years later, and then he starts looking at the side. Earworm Central, what can I say? Happy whiny, swirly, whirly thing. The one in the four time. I think this is the last section now, thankfully, because I start taking all the future stuff. It's also quite a cool effect. Educational show, please. There you go. Great. Oh, this is another controversial one. because apparently this is not the Dr. Snuggles theme that every other person on the planet remembers. So I've had a lot of controversy on this standalone video down the years, I can tell you. People were not happy with this. He's a pretty psychedelic guy. I mean, some of these are getting quite old, actually. I think some of these are probably more like borderline late 70s rather than 80s. Those flashbacks from another show I remember as well. That one with the clockwork egg, do you remember that? Was it Ludwig? Yeah. I don't know why I thought of him just then. It's the old school tech approach, you know. The wooden rocket ship and all that good stuff. I must have got some of these tapes off eBay, I think. I must have done even back then. I wonder when eBay started. Was eBay around in 2000-ish? Maybe. Family Ness, yeah. This was like sort of Chilton and the Wheelies kind of era, only a bit later, I think. Other people have got this up on YouTube. I checked when I came to this one last night when I was busy recording this, because I thought, I wonder if anyone else has actually got this one. They have. Just incredible, the lengths and the time that people have taken to actually capture this stuff for posterity. You literally can't find anything on YouTube, it's incredible. It's quite funny as well, because Fraggle Rock. Now again, see, this has a different versions. The Americans got a different version of this with a different lighthouse keeper and stuff. I'm not even sure if the Americans have lighthouses as a concept, but this was the British version, I think. I see some of these guys from the museum. I might have got off the original puppets. Jim Henson, of course. Jim Henson production. Dozers? I think they're called dozers. The faculty can actually eat what they build as well. It's like sugar cane or something for them. I don't know, what are these guys called? I can't remember what the giants are called. Look, Mama Fraggle. Ah, chuck away. There you go. Remember the gag. That would have broken his neck. I mean, let's face it, that's a bit harsh. There's Red. And sort of Mum Fraggle. Dan Fraggle Rock. Get along, gang. Yeah. Put one of my very early memories, so I do remember watching this. And I was very little. The caboose. You've definitely got to be of a certain age to remember this one. Definitely. I want to say he's like Montgomery Moose or something, because he's bound to be, isn't he? He's probably like Colin the Crocodile or Alan the Alligator or something like that. You can bet your bottom dollar, can't you? Remarkably long intro for a cartoon with animals in it. There's the caboose. There you go, Clubhouse Caboose. Is it Clubhouse Caboose? If it is, that's quite a shocking part of memory recall on my part. Fair dues to me. They get a lot of Muppet Babies. Another really mega popular one on my channel, which strangely never got a copyright claim. I've no idea why not. It never got a copyright claim. You know what, I did actually have a Fraggle Rock intro up as a separate video. I really should have had it, shouldn't I? What I may try and do is, if I do another channel, I will use that channel as a dumping ground for the stuff that would stop this one getting monetized. If I do that, I'll let you know. But the problem is, I think if I re-upload these cartoon intros now, I think I'll get stamped on harder now than it would have done when I originally put them up. So I'm just not sure whether or not they'll actually allow me to go up and stay up. If my Mysterious Cities of Gold experience is anything to go by, then I might have issues, but we'll have to see. So if I'm right, I've got about 6 minutes left to keep chatting away over most of the sound on these videos. Super Ted, one of the very, 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 if not the first show on Channel 4 S4C in the United Kingdom in 1980-something. So when the channel first started, this was what first came on, in English and Welsh versions, as I recall. And S4C's been, it's probably the longest running Welsh language channel, I think, these days. Or indeed that, that ever has been, full stop. So, it's got quite a history. I'm pretty sure Super Ted was one of the earliest ones on there. So there you go. What, older school than that? These tunes are pre-80s in terms of when they were made, but hey, you can't beat the classics. Well, as I recall, given the encoding quality of some of these, you can actually. But anyway, Captain Caveman! I turned that down for you a lot because he's louder. Here he is. I wonder how many of you seeing this will actually remember him or indeed have watched this far into the compilation. You never know. He's got a utility. I don't know what you'd call that. That's a Liam Mutley. And they're flying machines, no less. Catch the pigeon, anyone? It's a club. It was a club. That's what Captain gave man. It was a club, wasn't it? Yeah. Oh dear. Mutley, do something. Or I'll take your medals off you. He's always alright because he's got a tailed propeller. It's a funny show. And a new invention every week to try and catch the pigeon with. That was the gag. It's kind of a Wile E. Coyote Roadrunner kind of idea, you know? Because, like, they were never going to catch the pigeon, clearly. But they had some pretty random ideas and fun trying to. As you can see, it did not tend to end well for them. Get the feeling Mutley just isn't trying there. Dick Tracy. Check this out. Did a live action version of this with Warren Beatty at one point. I wouldn't say Madonna was in it, but I don't think she was. It was somebody else. This is proper old school cartoons, this. It really is. You can tell they were trying to keep the animation at a bare minimum, basically. The Valley of now, Freedom Force, this is quite an interesting one. If you think about what DC are doing now, this has got Hercules in it. It's got basically like Wonder Woman in it. But it's really early. So it's more to do with the kind of original myth type individuals rather than sort of the modern Marvel versions of them. So it's quite interesting like that. I wonder if this was on Force 5 in the States. Might have been. Yeah, this is a really random one. This, I remember getting this from the video store, and I remember this quite clearly from when I was very little. He just runs around being quite happy all the time. It's Paramount. Okay. Interesting. There he goes, bouncing. Yeah, run boy, run. Don't recognize any of those names. Don't know if I should. It's quite an interesting one. It's a very sort of quirky little cartoon. A little bit more thoughtful, I think, in some ways than some of them that are on. You know, it's just like got a little bit of something about it. I quite enjoyed it. He might be the last video. There might be one more. But I'm not sure. Ah, Mighty Mouse. Yeah. The Mighty Mouse Playhouse, apparently. Disney's gonna sue somebody. He's a super mouse, basically, but for reasons of copyright, he's a mighty mouse. Pooch, 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 pooch. Nice. it's definitely not Bravestarr. Sorry, dude. Pretty cool, though. Ah, Perils of Penelope Pit Stop. Classic. See, these old cartoons have shorter intros, so you can get more in the time. Help! This is one of my very early cartoon memories. Great villainess. Great villainy laugh, this guy. The Hooded Claw. That's it. He's the Hooded Claw. The Anthill Mob. How can I remember they call the Anthill Mob? That's how deeply cartoons get ingrained on your grey cells, kids. That is frightening that I remember they were called the Anthill Mob. It really is. There she goes. We know who you are. Yes, we do. See? We saw that coming a mile off. Oh, and the car was alive as well. That's right. I'm pretty sure it was a sentient car. Because they appeared in the Dastardly and Muttley Wacky Races show as well. Perishes. That was the dog, by the way. This was really badly coded. Sorry.
Roger Midget and his eagles fighting for our
so
freedom.
Random.
Fly through wind and outer space. Not a joy.
It's going to take me quite a while to do the list of all these, isn't it?
Roger Midget,
yeah.
He's our man, hero of our nation.
It could take some time.
For his adventures, just be sure and stay tuned to the
video. I think I actually had a menu on the VideoCD when it was actually a VideoCD where you could pick the individual episodes of it. Interest from it.
Roger and Jet, he's our man, hero of our nation. For his adventures, just be sure and stay tuned to the station.
It's still going. Secret scroll. Oh, check that out. Classic flying car that turns into a suitcase. Well, what more do you want? I mean, come on. He's got, I mean, Iron Man, eat your heart out. He's got a jetpack in his overcoat. I mean, fair dues to him. Nice. Bulletproof coat. Cannon in the head. That's what can I say? Interesting. Wow, I had some really random stuff at the back of it. Oh, Space Sentinels, here we go. I thought I'd run out of time by now. This one I remember really clearly from my childhood as well. It's just, when you're little, I don't think you need that much detail. You just need the ideas. And then your head fills in the blanks, especially when animation is this kind of level of quality, but for me it was the ideas that were really, really interesting. So this Hercules again, he was in that Freedom Force one a few minutes ago. Same character, but just appearing in a different show. And these were Filmation, I think, as well, these guys. Is it Filmation? Who's saying that rings a bell? Space Sentinels. Yeah, Filmation, there we go. 77. I think that might be it. That might, yep, yeah, I think that's the end. So there you are. I hope you've enjoyed those. I say far more than were actually ever on my channel. I've forgotten how many were on the disc that I didn't get around to bring up on the channel, because in those days I was on dial-up and I was probably paying to upload my own videos. That was a different era. Yeah. So, yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed that. We'll see if that can stay on the channel in a legitimate fashion. And I'll see if I can find a home for these separate videos. If not, I may just make them private. Because otherwise, if I move them to another channel, I'm going to lose all the comments and all the historical views. Nothing I can do about that, it seems, unfortunately. But there you go. So I hope you've enjoyed that. And I'll see you again.